In the beginning, there was nothing. Then, somehow, everything exploded into existence with an insane amount of energy. All that energy still exists all around us today. Energy moves objects. It's both a thing and a process. And it's easiest to observe when it's being transformed from one type to another. So welcome everyone to the unit on energy. In this video we'll cover energy, work, power, potential energy, kinetic energy, momentum and its relationship to kinetic energy, the work energy theorem, conservation of energy, machines, efficiency, and finally other sources of energy. So please take notes, follow the equations, and enjoy. So the first thing we're going to talk about in this unit is the idea of work. Now, work has to do with two different things. There has to be a force, and it has to push an object over a distance. So some examples of a force acting over a distance are, let's say, me drinking a cup of coffee, as I usually do, or maybe me getting in some sick reps. Oh, yeah. That's a good burn. Because in both situations, I pushed a force to move an object a certain distance. But let's check out a different scenario. All right, let's see what happens when I try to move this brick wall. Stop budging. Whew, not for a lack of trying. So in that situation, you might think that I did a lot of work because I'm picking up a sweat. However, my force did not move that wall, and because of that, no work was done. Now, when we bring this back to the classroom, the unit that you'll be using for work is going to be something called the joule. And so make sure you keep that in mind for every calculation you do. All right. So as we already talked about, in order to find work, all you need to do is take force times the distance. So let's read our problem. Calculate the work done when a force of 5 newtons moves a book 1.2 meters. What do we do first? That's right. Pick out what you know. We know we have a force of 5 newtons, and we know we have a distance of 1.2 meters. So let's set up the equation. If work is equal to force times distance, and we have a force of 5 newtons, with the distance of 1.2 meters, what's our final answer? That's right, 6 joules. Congratulations. It's time to begin, isn't it? I get a little bit bigger than that. I'll admit, I'm just the same as I was. Now don't you understand.
Okay. Take 2.
So the next thing we're going to be talking about is power. Power is the measure of how fast work is done. And it's actually measured using the unit, the watt, which is super exciting. So for this demonstration, I'm going to be running up the stairs as fast as possible, figuring exactly how much power I've used. And then I'm going to try it again one more time, only a little bit slower. So let's take a look at that. That was a lot of power. Let's try it again. Not too bad. Now let's take it back to the classroom. So you found work. Let's take it a step further and find power, huh? So power is work divided by time. Or we could combine the two equations and say power is force times distance divided by time. It means the same thing. Let's try out a problem. How much power is required to lift a 500 Newton barbell 2.2 meters in 1.2 seconds? How are we going to start this out? Darn right. We have 500 Newtons of force, 2.2 meters of distance, and 1.2 seconds as our time interval. So, let's set it up. If power is equal to force times distance
divided by time, then we have a force of 500 newtons, a distance of 2.2 meters, and a time of 1.2 seconds.
Plug that into your calculators real quick. I'll give you a second. Did you get it? Well, if you did, it'd be 917 watts. Problem number two, complete.